Bluff City Theater unveils its third season of professional theater in an intimate space. Now presenting Winwell's award-winning drama, Gertrude Stein and a Companion, directed by John Contini and starring Laura Ackerman as Gertrude and Susie Wall as Alice B. Toklas. You don't want to miss Gertrude Stein and a Companion at Bluff City Theater in historic downtown Hannibal.
Can you hear me? Now? Sometimes it takes some time, sometimes. I was 30 years old when I came to Europe to stay, and when I came, I didn't come to stay. But I did stay. You see, I was a San Francisco girl, and when the earthquake happened shortly after, I came to Europe with my friend Harriet. No, not a friend. Not really a friend. More than a companion or an acquaintance, but not a friend. There was only one friend, and that was Gertrude. How did it begin? Well, it happened naturally. That is to say that, naturally, it happened. One summer, I made myself the most practical hat out of a waste paper basket. A group of us in summer went to Italy, to Fiesole. We went several years each year, but that summer was different because Alice went as well. I have been very happy today. Your logic is happy. Logic is happy. Happy is not logic. Today I have been happy.
And I too.
And I have been very loved today.
Have I as well?
Oh yes, very.
No one has ever. I don't know how.
Well, didn't Liliana love you? Didn't Harriet love you?
I don't think they care, really.
Please care. Care for me. I care for you in every way possible. There is no one I could ever want or ever care for more.
Are you certain?
Certain.
I don't think there's anything to say more. You have guessed me, expressed me.
When all is said, one is weighed. We had filled the walls with such excitement, such things as had never been seen before. There were pictures by Picasso and Cezanne and Matisse and many, many more.
Gertrude liked all sorts of things.
Oh, but the things, the real things were the pictures. Never had there been such pictures. And all of them together, yet each one of them alone. And there will never be such things again. Only alone. Never again together. I remember once, Ernest Hemingway and Hadley, well, she was his first wife, Hadley was. Or perhaps it was Ernest and Pauline. It was one of his wives anyway, one of Ernest's wives. He was beginning to be famous and had written already one of those books. Any one of them. They were all the same in the same way that his wives were all the same. Alice had already decided she did not like him. And he, and this was his failure, did not like her. He had already come to it that he would not refer to her by name when he discussed us. And he did discuss us. He called us Gertrude Stein and a companion. The important thing is to have a sense of equality. And if you have that, anybody will do anything for you. And they did.
All but Ernest.
Well, Ernest would have had he not been
fragile.
You call Ernest fragile?
I do, very fragile.
Ernest the sportsman.
That is his image of himself, not mine. He was always breaking things. Anytime he did anything sporting, he broke something, his arm or his leg, or not often enough, his head. Sportsman, ha! It used to tire him out walking the few blocks from his place to ours.
You really have hated him. From the beginning, the first beginning.
Mabel Dodge, the very rich Mabel Dodge who could never decide on anything, really did decide from the beginning that she did not care for Alice. Alice, a sly little dog with angry gray eyes and black lashes and a drooping melancholy nose and drooping eyelids and ears which drooped under drooping oriental earrings. And her person was hung with barbaric drooping chains and jewels. She just drooped.
I have written everyone to tell them about Basket.
Oh, dear Basket, poor doll.
He was a dear animal, even being so famous. I have come to depend on his depending on me. There is no one to depend on me any longer, and I do need dependented.
You need what?
Dependented.
Dependented?
Dependented.
Where did you get such a word?
It seems a good word. Is it not a good word?
Well, I don't know if it's a good word. It certainly is delicious. Dependented, indeed. Oh, I like that. Dependented, indeed. There were those same people who questioned the things I wrote. What is it, they would ask? What is it? A rose is a rose is a rose. And I said, now listen. I said, listen, I am not a fool. I know that in everyday life we do not say a blank is a blank is a blank, but this is literature and not just statements. In that line, rose is a rose is a rose. The rose is red for the first time in English poetry in over 500 years. There is no difficulty. Just read the words on the paper. They're English. Just read them. Be simple, and these things will make sense to you. Miss Stern, to the average reader, your style, Latin, is perfectly comprehensible. All this foolishness about my writing being mystic or impressionistic is just so stupid. It's a lot of rot. I write as pure, plain, grammatical English as anyone else, more grammatically accurate than most. Well, there isn't a sentence of mine that a child couldn't diagram. Except perhaps for yourself. Mm-hmm. Well, then, Miss Stern, perhaps you would like to discuss this expatriate business. Now, you can listen to me, young lady. You don't know anything about it. Don't you dare call me an expatriate. I have generations of Americans behind me, and I'll...
I told them what you said.
Who?
Those reporters from the newspapers downstairs. Well, there's dozens of them.
What did you tell them?
Almost what you said.
Which was?
That you could not see them now because there were some things a lion could not do.
Alice, I told you. I said there was. I could not see them now because there were some things a girl could not do.
Lion is a more fitting word than girl, I thought. At this time here, with what we are doing here.
What are we doing here? They wanted me to do something for the cameras.
What do they want you to do?
Well, they suggested that I unpack our things, and I said, no. Miss Topless always unpacks our things, I said. So they said, well, why don't you answer the telephone? And I said, no. Alice always answers the telephone. So they said, well, what can you do? And I said, well, I can drink a glass of water. And I can put on and take off my coat. And that is what I did.
All at the same time, dear?
Yeah, to a certain degree.
Clever, very dear. And then there was the soldier. Oh.
Many, many soldiers.
True, but I am remembering the one who came to Kulo's and was billeted in the house we had there. With us. in the house and with us there.
There were always too many soldiers, always.
It was during the war, the second one.
And too many wars, always too many wars.
I would think so.
When that war began, there were those who cared for us, and a lot of people cared for us, who told us that being two Jewish ladies, we simply must leave.
But you told them you thought not.
I said thank you, but no. We, Alice and I, will stay here. We will pass this war here. Because Alice and I have always passed our wars in France.
Are you two ladies American?
American?
Us? Goodness, no. If you think you detect a slight bit of accent, I had an American nurse when I was a child.
Und wer were you, a child?
In Valencia. We're Spanish. Nosotros estamos españoles. Y católica as well.
I know your country very well. I spent a great deal of time there in my youth. I trained there and I studied there.
Oh, bueno, sí.
I am going to bed now. I hope I have not disturbed you too much. Good night.
Good night. Sleep well.
Time has a way of being, at times, almost timeless. And I sometimes, from time to time, cannot remember what year it is. It is 1961, and Paris is all a dither. The Kennedys are to come here. Oh, not here, not to 5 Rue Christine, but to Paris. And for that, the city is decorated with flags and buntings and perhaps even a student uprising or two for their entertainment. But that is not the matter. The matter is the pictures. They're gone. Rubina, the widow of my nephew Alan. Oh, you know Alan died. Well, Rubina has taken them away. And now they are stored in the vault at the Chase Manhattan Bank.
I have just committed murder in the kitchen. And now I shall sit here quietly and smoke till the police come and take me into custody.
You have killed the cook?
No, I haven't killed her. It was the carp.
The carp killed the cook?
The fish man sold it to me. He told me he would not have time to kill it, nor scale it, nor clean it, nor would he tell me with which of these horrible necessities one is to begin. And the carp is vital.
Why vital?
Pablo is coming.
Here?
This evening.
For what purpose?
To say goodbye to the picture.
The picture?
His portrait of you. It goes tomorrow to the Metropolitan in New York.
Oh. Well, that is proper, and as it should be, I did will that.
So you see, that is why I murdered the cop. The deed is done.
And that is that.
If one allowed oneself to do so, one could get quite accustomed to killing. I shall miss it.
You shall miss the killing?
No, I shall probably continue with that. I shall miss the portrait.
She was nearly 90 years old, and her beating heart stopped. She was placed beside me at Père Lachaise, the cemetery. And someone said, ladies and gentlemen, it is over. But was it? It was not.
No.